Namaste children, how are you all? I hope you are all safe at home. Shall we move to today's class? Before moving to today's class, we are going to recall the concept which we learnt in last class. So what we learnt about? Computers. So about computer and their uses. So what's the lesson name? Uses of computers. We learnt computer is a machine which do useful things and their uses like drawing, watching movies, okay, and then adding, and then play games, and then we learnt that computers can be used for writing letters too. So have you all clear about the concept, children? Yes, let us move to today's class. So today also we are going to see uses of computer. Before that, I want to ask a question. Can you able to see computers in some other place except in school? Yes, so I can able to grab your ideas like the places, bank, hospitals and railway station. If some people visited to some other countries, can able to see in airports, isn't it? Yes, and we can able to see in hospitals. Yes, so today we are going to see places where computers can be used, okay, in detail. First one, bank. So in bank, first of all, what is bank? Bank is a place where we will keep our money safe, isn't it? And only one person are using the bank? No, many people from that particular city are using that bank. So bank uses that computer for the main purpose to store the details of the people and their accounts. Okay, children, so how many people are having that account and how much of money they are having, everything will be stored in the computer. So when your parents want money to buy something, what they will do? They will go to bank. So their own person will be there in a counter, and he will check whether you have money in your account. If it is there, he will give money, isn't it? Yes, this for this purpose only they are using computers in bank. Okay, children. Next, in library. So what we have in library? We have many books to read, isn't it? And why we are using computers in library? Main purpose to store how much of books are there and their names and their location where it is there. Okay, for that purpose only we are using computers. So when you want to get a book from library, the librarian, what he will do? He will check the computer to see if it is there or not. If it is available, he will issue the book to you and make a note on the computer. Okay, so if it is a paperwork, paper and pen work, it will be very hard to store the entire details of the books, isn't it? So the computer make the work very easier. Next, in railway station. So in railway station we are using computers to book tickets. Okay, so if you want to travel from Chennai to some other place, you have to go to railway station and there will be a counter for ticket reservation center, and you have to go there and check it whether trains are available. Okay, if it is available, he will get money from you and issue the ticket. Okay, for storing that details and train timings, they are using computer in the railway station. Have you all clear, children? Yes. In school, why we are using? We are using to learn about computers. So computers are used in school mainly for teaching, and students, they will learn computer skills. Next, airport. Likewise in railway station, right? To book tickets, you can go to airport and see the information about ticket reservation and bookings for ticket bookings, and then it will keep record of the all the passengers who are all traveling. Okay, next one, hospital. Why we are using computers in hospital? Who the person who will come to hospital? Patients, right? It will keep the record of the patients, and it is helpful in doing medical test. Okay, children, have you all clear about the concept, places where we can use computer? Yes. So next we are going to see things which computer cannot do. So we can't able to say that everything can computer can do. There are some things which it cannot do. Can we see that one? Here, first one. You can use fridge to keep food items. Can a computer be used like a fridge? Can you able to store your sweets and fruits in the computer? No, it cannot. Okay, and then your mother will make a fresh juice using a mixer, isn't it? So can a computer can be used as a juicer, mixer? No, it cannot. Okay, and you are all washing your clothes in washing machine. Can a computer can be used like that? No. Okay, they are all doing their specific task. Okay, but computer cannot do that things and all. Okay, have you all clear about the children? Apart from that, some other examples. You are using AC, isn't it, in your home? Can your computer can be used like that? No. Yes, and you are having fan in your home. Can your computer can be used like that? No. Okay, children. Have you all clear about that? The things that computer cannot do? Okay. So that's all our today's concept. Let us move to the vocabulary words. First word we have bank. Spelling B-A-N-K. Second word school. S-C-H-O-O-L. And we have library. L-I-B-R-A-R-Y. And fourth one airport. A-I-R-P-O-R-T. And the fifth one, railway station, R-A-I-L-W-A-Y, railway station, S-T-A-T-I-O-N. Practice these vocabulary words, okay, children? Read aloud and see and write in your notebook. Next, you have worksheet activities 1 and 2, okay? So, you have to tick the places where computer can be used and put a cross where computer cannot be used. There are four pictures are there. First one bank and the second one a hill. Okay. And then third one railway station and fourth one tree. So think and do it. Okay, ma. Okay. Next one. In what activities can computer be used? You have to place a tick mark where you think they can be used and a cross where you think they cannot be used. Okay, first one, a boy is eating a lollipop. Can a computer can be used for eating a lollipop? Think and do it. Sugas is listening to music. Can a computer be used to listen to music? Okay, and then Jeet is adding numbers on a slate. Can he use a computer to add numbers? Okay, these are the questions. Think and do it. Okay, finally, thank you, students.